Houston to Kansas to Chicago.
What's good?
Hip hop and R&B
all day.
In Chicago 77.3.
Yeah.
All right, this is Ryan Woodcock, a.k.a. Bloodhound. You know, I'm rocking with DJ Malone, showing y'all love and support, man. That's what's up.
Yeah, it is.
Turn your speakers up.
Hey, man.
This is Chicago 77.3.
Right now.
All right.
Get in tune.
It's the one and only DJ Malone. How you guys doing, man? Chicago 77.3, the best place to be at on any day, really. How you guys doing? I'm doing okay, man. I'm out here chilling. I ain't gonna lie, it's a little bit cold, a little bit chilly, but you know what, though? We're gonna keep on pushing, keep on moving. I'm still bringing you people who are on the rise, people who are on the move, and people I just want to talk to. So the next person I got coming up, man, and people from the South, man, please get behind this guy, man. I really like the support and everything, man. He got an EP album coming. We're going to talk about it. It's called Year of the Hound, and I got the guy who created it and everything. Go in and introduce yourself real quick.
What's up, man? Yeah, Ryan Woodcock, Blood, a.k.a. Bloodhound. You know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Get out my way. You know, call me anything except late for dinner.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Definitely, man, definitely. Hey, I do appreciate you being on the show, Ryan. So I want to go into a time machine real quick. I want my listeners to get to know about you and then how you got into everything. So let's go into a time machine. Where did this all start for you?
Well, you know, I've been playing music since I was 14 years old, from the time of, you know, 14 to, like, you know, 17, well, 16, 14 to 16, I was really into music until I got in high school and hit the street and got my heart broke and lived life a little bit and swung around, got back to the music, mid-20s or what have you, went to Nashville, things kind of didn't work out. But come back to the music again a couple years later, and all of a sudden, man, my music, if you would listen to it, it started to transition towards hip-hop and more so what this new genre they got out now called hip-hop. And as I was listening to music, I noticed that hip-hop has something out called drill music, which is real popular in, like, Chicago and down here in New Orleans where I'm, you know, by me. And so I was thinking about, well, they got drill music. Well, I'm going to make hill music, basically, you know, rapping about being raised in South Mississippi, you know, our environment, what we may encounter throughout the day. And so I said, you know what, if the music begins to sound like hip-hop, it is what it is. Let's ride with it. And it's taking off. It's literally blown my mind.
I like that. Growing up, who were some of your influences?
Notorious B.I.G. and Tupac is always said when this question is asked to many artists, you know what I'm saying? But I really have to say my first rap song that I ever learned was Tupac. My second rap song I ever learned was Coolio of Gangster's Paradise. I got to ride on an airplane with him from Mississippi, from Houston to Atlanta. You know, really cool guy. Rest in peace, Coolio. And one of my big influences, I would say, is Haystack, a rapper from Nashville, Tennessee, which I actually got to do a couple songs with, and I actually got to do a sold-out show with last year, too. So that was a real big thing for me.
Okay. I like that. That's what's up, man. I really like that you're different, man. And I mean that in the most best way. And because I like the fact that somebody that comes from this area and gets it out the mud and really grinds and really goes out and says, hey, yo, this is who I am and this is what I'm about. I can respect that all the way.
Yeah. Well, my music is a reflection of what people may go through, especially today in the environment that we're living in right now. But one thing that I didn't want to happen, when you listen to hip hop, they all talk about the same thing. You listen to hip hop, they all talk about the same thing. They all talk about four wheel drives, trucks and bonfires, and the hip hop's talking about rims, guns and, you know, clubs. But my music, when you listen to it, I want people to relate to it as in, you know, I went through what he's talking about, you know what I'm saying? And yeah. So I got that influence too from Haystack, just talking about people in real life situations. That way people can relate to my music, but at the same time, it's also got me in trouble. That's why I believe I'm the most banned artist on the internet. But, you know, it is what it is.
And why do you think that is? Is it because you're free and outspoken? Why do you think that is?
Oh, yeah. I'm definitely free and outspoken. My big thing that I'm pushing right now is freedom of speech, which, you know, they're taking away. If you listen to the first track on this new album, The Year of the Hound, the song, The Year of the Hound, is pretty much a song about free speech and how it's being attacked. I've had Facebook permanently kick me off twice. They banned the VIN or whatever that number is. I've had TikTok permanently kick me off once. On top of being kicked off and accounts kicked off, you know, dozens of times. And then, you know, I just got off a 30-day ban from Facebook for quoting some lyrics in my song, which if you just read it, it kind of does sound... The lyric that I quoted was from my song Pink Flamingo, and it was the last verse, and it goes, I'll kill you over him, Bubba, and won't think twice, talking about my grandfather. Well, most people feel this way about their family. If somebody messes with your family, you know what I'm saying, you're going to defend them, take up for them, I'll kill you, won't think twice. You know, you get that feeling sometimes, and I talk about it. And so it just conflicts with social media from time to time, which unfortunately decides who becomes famous and who makes it and who don't.
Well, I think what it is, man, is that with like social media is making people believe, okay, well, this is the way you're supposed to feel. And that's not how it is, man. Life is life. Life is, you know what I'm saying? I can't express to people, hey, yo, how many times, hey, yo, man, this is how I feel. And a lot of people will say, oh, I go against the grain because I feel that way. No, that's what it is. I have the right to feel and think the way I want to feel.
Right. Yeah. Especially in this country. But I really feel like I kind of know this because I look at the numbers and look at the statistics of my music, the followers, the analytics that Spotify and Reverb Nation provide, and what little bit that Facebook provides. I know that if I hadn't been kicked off and banned and went through all this constantly, I would have a much bigger following and a much bigger audience. And so that's why I say in my song, you know, I'm building this here brick by brick, and I really am, you know, each brick being a fan.
Hey, and you're going to get there, man. You're going to get, they always censor the people that they know are the strongest.
Okay, for real. For real.
So let's talk, and you know, we're talking about the Year of the Hound, so let's talk about that. Now, why that title?
Well, I just feel like, you know, it's my year, and somebody that is not a fan or never heard my music, they'll probably read that if they come across it and get curious enough to click on it or listen to it. Like, is he talking about a dog? Like, who's he talking about? And then even after you get done listening to the song, you still may not understand what is the Year of the Hound, but you will know that freedom of speech is under attack in this country, which is the main message, the main point. You know, I'm trying to push, because I feel if we lose that, then we lose hip-hop. I mean, I remember they tried to shut Tupac down in the early 90s, and it went to court, and they won over freedom of speech. So, you know, if we lose that, we lose hip-hop.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think you know what I'm saying, hip-hop was, you know, founded on basic rules of, hey, yo, man, a state of represent. Like, hey, yo, this is who we are. And then it became a global phenomenon because it's like, okay, everybody wants to be hip-hop. And we're coming into the 50-year anniversary of hip-hop, which is amazing to me because hip-hop is now, I would feel, the main genre of everything.
Yeah, yeah. I do too. You notice when you watch basketball games or football games, if you, like when I was growing up, right before they go to commercial break, you know, that'd be a rock and roll song playing or whatever. And sometimes now there still is. But mainly now, when they'll cut to commercial break, you know, it's going to be a hip-hop song, you know, which is great for the genre. And I think it's really pushing music forward.
Yeah, definitely is. So let me ask you this. What's one of your favorite songs off of the Year of the Hound?
I got two favorites. Flip is pretty cool. I like that one. I performed that one live last Saturday in at Pop Saloon in Jackson, Mississippi. And I had the whole crowd scream, you know, flip it. I had them all yelling, flip is good. There's a song on there that's my favorite, though, that, believe it or not, right now is not getting a lot of plays. We're watching the numbers right now since the album's been released. And my favorite song on the album is getting the less plays, and the name of that song is Altar Call. And, I mean, I don't know why it's not getting enough plays or whatever, but we're going to have to maybe look at it with an ad campaign or something. But that's my favorite song simply because of what it talks about. You know what I'm saying? It kind of challenges people and their beliefs.
And so with that being said, and I'm going to flip it a little bit. What was one of the hardest songs off of the what is a song off of this album that's really made you vulnerable or really made you speak out?
I would say the song the Year of the Hound. It was kind of hard to put together to get with the girls who done the chorus, you know, working with their schedule, and I had two female vocalists do the chorus, and so and then what the statement of it all and what it's saying. When I first heard the beat, I was like, man, this is gonna be a hit. I gotta do this beat justice, because I've heard some people take some great beats and write some shit lyrics, but when I heard it, I was like, man, the beat alone is gonna sell, so I gotta, you know, use my talent, and not for my benefit, but I need to express a greater cause, which is, you know, the freedom to be able to express yourself.
Okay, I like that. So now coming into it, and we're in 23 now, what's planned for you, man? What's next?
I'm glad you asked that. So, quick story, I was dropping some of my CDs off at a local shop here in Mississippi, Gulfport, Mississippi, called where they sell my albums, and there was a guy that waited on me, and he was a rapper. His name is Tank, and he's one of the rappers for autism, and he teamed up with me. He said, man, look, he said, I got a doctor's clinic down here in Gulfport, Mississippi. They can't raise enough funds to get a virtual headset for their patients that are autistic children. He said, if you put on an event, you know, with your name and a couple of your buddies like Haystack and Colt Ford, we can draw a crowd and build up enough funds and, you know, maybe get the doctor's office that VR headset. So we got a meeting the 11th of this month. So we're probably fixing to team up with Rappers for Autism and, make that happen. We're going to put on an event, put on a concert. There's a GoFundMe link and all that. But I'm just really focused right now on Rappers for Autism.
That's dope. I like to hear stuff like that, man. Giving back. That's what it is.
Yeah, man. I was really influenced and emboldened by meeting this guy, too, man. He's just one of these people that he took his talent and basically dedicated it to a health crisis like autism.
That's dope as hell, man. So who, let me ask you this, who would you like to work with going into the future?
I just want to work I just want to work with another hungry, talented artist. You know, there's a lot of artists out here, but, you know, there's not a whole lot of talent. I'm actually signed with a distribution deal to Bentley Records right now, and I had an opportunity to do a song with Rick Ross, T-Pain, a couple others. I had an opportunity to do a song with them last year. I passed on it. Just wasn't, that my headspace really wasn't right. But if that swings back around, I'd really like to do a song with like Rick Ross, T-Pain, somebody of that nature.
Now, bro, where would you, if you could perform anywhere, where would it be at and why?
I'd like to perform at Coachella. I just think that would be awesome. You know, when we did the Haystack show, it was a pretty big crowd. I like that energy. You got to know how to do it, though. You got to know how to bring that energy. You got to know how to give that energy and receive that energy. You know what I'm saying? That's what it's all about. That you know.
Hey, I understand. Trust me. See, the energy is everything in the concert or in a party. Anything that you're out and in front of people, energy is everything.
Right.
So, definitely, man. Well, I'm excited for you. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. I really am excited for you, right? And I really like how you approach it and everything. So, give us a Facebook, and Twitter, everything where they can find you.
I just tell people go to Google and type in Ryan Woodcock Bloodhound. And it'll pull everything up for you. I've done had to delete and remake and delete and remake so many accounts on all the social media companies, apps. I just tell people, look, just Google me.
hey, Google me. I'm Googleable. Hey, that's what I like. That's what's up, man. That's what's up. Okay.
Let me say, man, I'm really pretty... You doing, man? I really appreciate, you know, what you're doing, reaching out to artists, man, sharing your platform, giving us a platform, giving us a voice. This is what freedom of expression and freedom of speech is all about.
Oh yeah, man. Because at the end of the day, man, you're artists, and the thing in artists is art. You know what I'm saying? So I never want that ever to be taken away from you guys to where you can't be an artist and speak your truth, because without freedom of speech, there's essentially there is no art.
Bingo. Right.
So I just appreciate you and everything that you got going on, man. So let me, before you go, anything you want to say to your stalkers, your lovers, your supporters?
I really just want to talk to everybody in the Chicago area. Listen, I grew up outside of New Orleans. I had a murder charge at 19 years old. I get it. But, man, we got to put these guns down, man. You know, just killing each other's got to stop. And I'm literally dedicating my whole life. Bloodhound will die getting this message out. And for anybody that to receive that, man, that's what I kind of want to give a shout out to. Anybody that will receive, because it's wrote for many, but only chosen for few. You feel me?
Hey, that's what it is, man. That's what it is. So, hey, man, Brian, I do appreciate you. And you need anything, don't be a stranger, man. Don't be a stranger.
All right, man. I appreciate it, man.
All right, man. I appreciate you, Ron.
All right, DJ.
All right, appreciate you.
Right.
Turn your speakers up.
Hey, man.
This is Chicago 77.3.
Right now.
All right.
Get in tune.